Hello, Snapshot today. I'm here at Cottonwood Elementary School, and Mrs. Alamo, you're from Texas?
Yes.
Mrs. Alamo from Texas, who's now, and we're all blessed, here at Cottonwood Elementary School. We've talked about, we know a little bit about MGP and student growth percentiles, and Mrs. Alamo in three areas, all three elementary areas, fifth grade. All three elementary areas had the maximum growth, which is difficult to do. And so let's talk about that for just a minute.
My kids are awesome.
Uh-huh.
They're great. I mean, they're all different.
Yeah.
And I have three kids of my own, so I know exactly, and all my kids are all different. I have one child who has a learning disability. He struggles in his homework. He is a fifth grader as well, and so I think I'm able to kind of understand what he's going through. Mm-hmm. And that helps me better understand my students in the classroom. And when I started school, I didn't know any English. I didn't speak. I didn't understand English at all. And I would go home in tears. And I'd be asking my parents, you need to help me. And they would be like, we can't help you with this. And so I was blessed to have great teachers who just pushed me and motivated me and wouldn't let me down. There's like failure is not an option. And so I kind of have that sense with my students where failure is not an option.
Is that when you decided you wanted to be a teacher?
Yes, second grade.
Now, across the district, we've got like 4,000 teachers, and 174 of them had MGPs that were higher than 70. So you had in three areas, I mean, perfect, 99s.
Wow.
So you really have to focus on each kid. You can't let any of them.
I can't. And it kind of drives me crazy sometimes.
So how do you do it? How do you keep track of them?
I talk to them. I call their parents. I say, how can I help them? You know, I'm here to help them. I ask the parents, can I keep them in from recess? They're struggling in these areas. I don't have enough time. You know, having that rapport with them, you know, and being a friend to them and having high expectations, saying, this is where I came from. You have no excuse.
Uh-huh.
We're going to do this together. And they kind of feel... They feel like, oh, well, Mrs. Alamo did it. I can totally do this, too.
Do they know what goals you've set?
Yes.
And
I talk to them. Okay, you know what? I know you can't write 5 paragraphs. I know that's a little overwhelming for you. But by the end of fifth grade, you will be able to do this. But let's start at 1 paragraph. And let's just start increasing a paragraph in your essay every month. And they're like, oh, now I could do that. And so they start doing it little by little.
Oh, you're marvelous. Thank you so very much.